Compost is an organic fertilizer produced from the decomposition or decay of organic materials by microorganisms such as bacteria and fungi. These materials can include plant residues, leaves, straw, and weeds, kitchen scraps, fruit and vegetable peels, animal manure, and other organic waste. This process converts organic materials into a stable, nutrient-rich product that can increase fertility and improve soil structure. Materials used: plant waste, dry leaves, straw, grass, grass clippings, corn stalks, etc., kitchen scraps, fruit peels, vegetable scraps, coffee grounds, etc., animal manure. Other organic waste. Manufacturing process: natural decomposition. The natural decomposition of organic matter by microorganisms. This process can take a very long time without assistance. Composting. A rapid process for decomposing organic matter, usually taking only 1 to 3 months. Activator. The addition of decomposing microorganisms such as bacteria or fungi, e.g., Trichoderma sp. or M4 solution, can speed up the composting process. Compost has numerous benefits for soil fertility, improving plant health, reducing organic waste, and improving the environment. Its primary benefits include increasing soil nutrient content, improving soil structure and aeration, increasing the soil's air-holding capacity, and supporting the growth of beneficial microorganisms that suppress pests and plant diseases. Benefits for soil and plants: improve soil fertility. Compost enriches the soil with essential nutrients such as nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium, as well as organic matter, which is essential for healthy and vigorous plant growth. Improves soil structure. Compost makes the soil looser, improves aeration, and makes it easier for plant roots to grow strong. Improves water holding capacity. Compost helps the soil retain water longer, reducing the need for watering and making plants more drought tolerant. Suppresses pests and diseases. Compost contains beneficial microorganisms that can naturally suppress the growth of pests and diseases in plants. Increases soil pH. Compost can help improve and stabilize soil pH, especially in soils that are too acidic due to rainfall. Environmentally beneficial: reduces organic waste. Composting recycles organic waste such as food scraps and leaves into useful products, thereby reducing the amount of waste sent to landfills. Reduces pollution. By reducing reliance on chemical fertilizers, compost helps reduce the risk of water and soil pollution. Furthermore, processing organic waste at home is preferable to rotting in the trash, which can produce potent methane gas. Sequesters carbon. Compost helps the soil absorb and store carbon, which contributes to reducing greenhouse gas emissions and combating global warming. The fermentation time for organic compost varies, but generally takes about 1 to 4 weeks to produce mature compost. A faster process, around 24 hours to 1 day, can be achieved with special techniques such as express bokashi. Fermentation times can be longer, up to 29 days, if the materials used contain oil, such as coconut pulp. Factors affecting fermentation time. Material type. Materials that are rich in oil or have a high carbon to nitrogen ratio, C/N, take longer to decompose. Methods and activators. Using activators such as EM4 can significantly speed up the process. Compost pile maintenance. Turning the compost pile regularly, for example, every 2 days, to ensure good water circulation will speed up fermentation. Characteristics of mature compost. Color. Dark brown, like soil. Odor. Not foul, but rather earthy. Temperature. Not hot to the touch. Texture. Loose and not damp. Presence of worms. The presence of earthworms is a sign that the compost is ready to use. Compost can be applied to plants by mixing it into the soil when planting, as a mulch layer around the plants, or by sprinkling it on the surface and mixing it into the soil. Choose a method that suits your plant's needs, such as mixing the compost into potting soil or spreading it over your vegetable garden or lawn. Application method when planting. Dig a hole, add a handful of compost to the bottom, cover with a little soil, and then plant the seedling on top. Make sure the roots don't come into direct contact with the compost to avoid damage. As mulch. Spread a 1/2 to 1 inch, 1.25 to 2.5 centimeters, layer of compost around the base of plants or over the entire surface of the bed. This method helps maintain soil moisture and suppress weeds. To refresh the soil, mix 1 inch, 2.5 centimeters, of compost into the top layer of soil twice a year, or when transplanting plants to larger pots. For potting, mix 2 parts screened compost with 1 part sand or perlite to create a new growing medium. For larger, nutrient-heavy plants, apply a 1/2 inch, 1.25 centimeters, layer of compost monthly around the base of plants like tomatoes and squash. Additional tips: direct contact. Avoid applying compost directly to the stems or roots of plants, especially young ones. Avoid this to avoid heat and damage. Adjust the amount. Apply the right amount of compost. Adding too much compost regularly can upset the soil's pH balance. Use liquid compost. If you have liquid compost, you can apply it by spraying it on the plants or mixing it with water when watering. The best time to apply organic compost is during land preparation or before planting seedlings. Base fertilizer, compost can also be applied as a follow-up, but more frequently, for example, once a week or once every 2 weeks, and is best applied as a liquid organic fertilizer, POC, by spraying it in the morning or evening. Application as a base fertilizer when? During land preparation before planting seedlings. Function: provides long-term fertility, improves soil structure, and supports soil microbial life. Follow-up application form: use fertilizer, POC, to improve plant absorption and prevent soil damage. Time: morning, 6 o'clock to 9 a.m. Sick, 4 o'clock to 6 p.m. Frequency: dry season, once a week. Rainy season, once every 3 days. Important: do not spray during hot sun or before rain to prevent fertilizer leaching or evaporation. Ensure the fertilizer is dispensed first, generally 1 liter of liquid fertilizer per 100 liters of water, to avoid an overdose that could damage the plants. Plants that thrive after being fertilized with compost show signs of improved overall health and growth. Key signs include: increased leaf growth. Plants will have more leaves and larger leaf sizes. This occurs because the nutrients in compost improve soil texture and increase nutrient uptake for more efficient photosynthesis. Brighter green leaf color. Healthy, thriving leaves are typically a deep, bright green, indicating adequate nutrition, especially nitrogen. Increased plant height. Plants will experience faster and more significant vertical growth compared to plants not fertilized with compost or the control, indicating a positive response to nutrient availability. Disease and pest resistance. Plants that receive adequate nutrients from compost tend to be stronger and more resistant to pests and diseases. Improved flower or fruit production. For plants that produce flowers or fruit, successful compost application will be evident in increased yields and quality. Improved soil condition. In addition to changes in the plant, the quality of the soil around the plant will also improve, becoming looser, having better water circulation, and smelling like healthy forest soil, no foul odor.